Are you ready to unlock the power of stable diffusion without breaking the bank on a high-end CPU? Whether you're a tech enthusiast or just someone looking to explore the exciting world of AI, you're in for a treat. In this video, we're about to embark on a journey into the realm of stable diffusion using a free Google Colab notebook. Not only can you dive into the fascinating world of AI, but you can also tailor it to your preferences by installing the models of your choice. So, without any more suspense, let's dive right into the heart of this adventure. The process is straightforward, but it's important to follow along in the video to avoid encountering errors. We'll be using a Google Colab notebook, and all credit goes to the person who generously shared this valuable resource. To get started, head to the Runtime menu and select Change Runtime. Make sure to choose the T4 GPU. By default, it's usually set to use your CPU. Once that's done, click the Save button and then hit Connect to link up with the GPU. With the initial setup completed, go to the first cell and click Run. This will execute the code, but be patient as it can take 3 to 4 minutes to finish. Once the first step is finished, you'll see a green checkmark on the first cell. Before moving on to the next step, click on the provided blue link. Here, you'll find various stable diffusion models that you can install in the Google Colab notebook. The default selection is usually Stable Vision Realistic version 5. If you wish to install a different version, like Stable Diffusion version 5, simply replace the false value with true. However, for now, let's proceed with the default choice. If you want to install your preferred models from the Civit AI, Common Visual Interface, I'll show you how to do that later in the video. For now, run the second cell. This process may also take a few minutes, so patience is key. Occasionally, you might see an error message, but don't worry. It's part of the process, not an actual error. If it does occur, just run the cell again. Once the second step is complete, and you see the green checkmark on the second cell, proceed to run the third cell. Wait for the Invoke AI link to appear. It's essential not to open it until you see the final link. Now, click on the first link, where you'll find the Stable Diffusion tool inside Invoke AI. You can enter your prompts, use a negative prompt if needed, and specify the number of images and steps. You'll also see a list of installed models. If you'd like to install other models, click on the Model Manager, select Import Model, and paste the link to your desired model. I'll demonstrate how to do this using Civit AI in the video. I'm going to Civit AI, where you can find all of the stable diffusion models. Let's say I want to install this model because it's a very realistic model. Simply go to the download button and copy the link address. Then, get back to the Invoke AI and paste your link here. Select Add Model. This can take some time to add your model. You can see our model has been added. This might take a bit of time to add your model, but once it's done, it will appear in the list. Now, in the text-to-image section, you'll find the Epic Photogasm model. It's easy to use. Try a prompt like, a beautiful lady with freckles in a coffee shop, hyper-realistic, and select Invoke to generate the image. Here's the final image, which looks quite decent. If you wish to upscale it, you have the option to do so. Click on the Upscale button and choose your desired upscaling model. For instance, I'll select Real S4X Plus, then click Upscale Image. This is the upscaled version of the image. To download it, click on the image and select Download Image. The picture is really nice. It has great expression. When experimenting, you have countless setting possibilities. You have various options, such as seed values, the number of images, the number of steps, and a canvas option. Just try it out. That's how you can use Stable Diffusion in Google Colab without any cost. I hope you find this video helpful. All the necessary links can be found in the video description. If you're interested in more advanced AI-related tutorials or have questions, feel free to leave a comment. Show your support with a like and subscribe for more engaging content. Until next time, take care, and I'll see you in our next exploration.